Students, we will look at the last part of jet propulsion, that is a rocket propulsion. These rocket engines are non-breathing type, which carry both the fuel and the oxidizer on board, and therefore they cannot be, and therefore they are not dependent on the atmospheric surrounding atmosphere for the needed supply of oxygen. Accordingly, they provide the primary means of propulsion in the outer space. We will see a simplified diagram of a liquid propellant engine. Rocket engine. The fuel and oxidizer, that oxidizer liquid oxygen here, are stored in separate tanks and are pumped in a carefully metered fashion into a combustion chamber where they are atomized, mixed and burnt. The products of combustion are discharged from the combustion chamber through a nozzle where it is expanded to low pressure but a high velocity jet. The high velocity jet produces the thrust in the opposite direction to propel the rocket through the air. Because liquid propellant rockets can be restarted and fully adjusted, they have become the primary propulsion in the space program. Now let us look at the rocket engine. This is the direction of the engine rocket. Okay, we will see the diagram. You can see this is a complete diagram. Now you can think to see this is the direction of the rocket. Here you have got FT, fuel tank, and this is the hydrogen peroxide tank, and this is the oxidizer tank, the liquid oxygen. So you have got a liquid fuel and here you have got a liquid oxidizer. For both of them there are two separate pumps. One pump is for the fuel and another pump is for the oxidizer. Both are liquids, so you have got pump and they are pumped in this combustion chamber. This is the combustion chamber here. So in this combustion chamber there is a igniter also which will burn. The fuel is burnt in this combustion chamber, and from that it is passing through this nozzle. This is a nozzle, and when it is passing through the nozzle, then the pressure energy is converted into high velocity and that is exhausted to the atmosphere. This high hot gases are exhausted through the high velocity, hot exhaust gases are exhausted to the atmosphere, and this gets the propulsion for the rocket to move forward. So you have got a fuel tank, you have got an oxidizer tank, you have got two pumps, you have got a combustion chamber and a nozzle. As simple as that. Okay, this is what the liquid propellant engine rocket engine looks like. Solid propellant engines are used. They are used only for the takeoff stage or for the first stage, because controlling the solid propellant is slightly difficult. Solid fuel releasing in a controlled rate is difficult. The control of the thrust, however, is limited, making the solid propellant rockets only suitable for the first or the takeoff stage of the space rockets. Once again, I repeat, this is a rocket. You can see the shape of the rocket. Here you have got a fuel tank, a huge fuel tank, you have got a huge oxygen tank. And these two tanks are connected to two different pumps. Okay, you can connect it this way, one pump this way, one pump for the oxidizer. Both of them come to the combustion chamber. This is a combustion chamber where they are burnt. They are sent in a metered quantity. They are atomized into fine spray. Here they are burnt. When they are burnt, high pressure gases come out. When the pressure further increases due to the combustion, then they are passed out through a nozzle. And in this nozzle, the high pressure gases are converted into low pressure but high velocity. The high velocity exhaust gases are sent out, and this high velocity gases going out produce the opposite thrust or reaction for the rockets. So they are called reaction engines, and that is why these are called as rocket engines, and they carry their own oxidizer that can be a liquid oxygen, and they carry their own fuel. Our turbojet, turboprop, they carry their own fuel. But here in the rocket engines, because they are non-breathing type, they go beyond the atmospheric limit of the earth, so they need to carry their own oxidizer. And this is how they work on the principles of the Newton's third law of motion. And because of the exhaust, high velocity exhaust gases going on, they produce a thrust which moves the rocket in the required direction. Thank you.